Brothers and sisters, the purpose of narrating today's beautiful hadith is just to make us realize how much freedom and respect Islam bestows upon our females, particularly when they marry to a man and become their life partner. In Sahih Muslim, book number 18, hadith number 4251, Hazrat Aisha reports that Hind, the daughter of Utbah, wife of Abu Sufyan, came to Allah's Messenger, may peace be upon him, and said, Abu Sufyan is a miserly person. He does not give adequate maintenance for me and my children, but I am constrained to take from his wealth some part of it without his knowledge. Is there any sin for me? Thereupon Allah's Messenger, may peace be upon him, said, take from his property what is customary, which may suffice you and your children. This hadith has been narrated on the authority of Hashim with the same chain of traditions as well. According to another tradition, in book number 18, hadith number 4253, Sahih Muslim, Hazrat Aisha is said to have reported that Hind came to Allah's Apostle, may peace be upon him, and said, Messenger of Allah, by Allah, there was no other household upon the surface of the earth than your household, about which I cherished Allah bringing disgrace upon it. And now there is no other household upon the surface of the earth than your household, about which I cherish Allah granting it honor. Allah's Apostle, may peace be upon him, said, it is so. By him in whose hand is my life, she said, Allah's Messenger, Abu Sufyan is a niggardly person. Is there any harm for me if I spend upon his children out of his wealth without his permission? Thereupon Allah's Apostle, may peace be upon him, said, there is no harm for you if you spend upon them what is reasonable. The hadith clearly suggests that in Islam, relations are more important, not wealth. If you have all the wealth of the world and your wife is not happy because you are not kind, condescending and caring to her, then you are the most worthless person of the world. According to another saying of Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, the best among you are those who are best with their women, and I am the best among you in my dealings with my wives. Another beautiful aspect of these ahadith is the concern of Sahaba and Sahabiyat Ridwanullah alayhim ajma'in about their conduct in life. To know the opinion of Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in their day-to-day matters of life was the most important thing for them, as they knew that the success is only in the way that is recommended by Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. May Allah make us all loving, caring, respectful and condescending to one another. Ameen. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyyil ummi wa alihi wa sallam.